नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन रेस्पेक्टिव एंड वेरियस डोमेन्स, लेट मी टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट मच फर्दर. आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट द सक्सेस डेफिनेशन and its limitations, how you need to define success. Prior to that video, I was talking about the various practices that you do to cultivate that habit. And I was even talking about being patient, perceive, and go in a systematic and schematic way. Let's take this subject much further. Let me not get into the Vedas or Upanishads or anything. Let me talk this in a simple layman terms, which could be more easier for the individuals to understand how to get to that goalpost or the aim post. The point is, today we are failing again on this factor or the cofactor for understanding true definition of success, which needs to be introspected itself as well as external. Now, have we ever tried asking ourselves a question? If not, if hypothetical question, today is my last day, I need to work on this. What is it that needs to be done? Have you ever tried asking this? By the way, this is what big CEOs or someone high-profiled CEOs think. Considering that the present situation that you are in, if it was your last day, how do you take that decision? Last minute or last minute decision making? What is it that you want to do? What is it that you want to do? It is applicable across domains, be it finance, be it music, be it medical field, be it science and research work, be it R&D. It's applicable. be it learning tantras, be it learning mantras, be it learning ritualistic practices, across all domains. What is it that I will be achieving out of this action? For a moment of time, we think about today. Let's think about today. If today is the last day, how would it impact? At the same time, how will it impact at a long range? Let's say you are not there. What is it that impact of this message going to happen? Impact of actions, impact of reactions on the society. What is that one good thing that you are giving away? What is that one takeaway, or what is that one pointer that you are giving on a permanent basis to the society towards betterment, making him or her a perfect gentleman? Not really perfect, but near to perfection. What am I about to do today? That one very good thing that will help the society. An act, be it dance, specifically this is applicable for classical dance. A dance or the music concert will be for 1 hour, 1.5 hour, 3 hours, or half an hour, or 20 minutes, or 10 minutes, or 5 minutes. In those few minutes, what is the message, end message that you are giving? What is the benefit that you are giving to the society? Have we ever tried asking this? By the way, this cannot be trained or inculcated or imbibed or inscribed in the minds of the individual by guru, by teacher, or anyone. It has to be instilled by the individual who takes that initiative. Specifically for a guru or a teacher, or for an orator, for a speaker, or for a person like me who is giving videos or creating videos, what is the takeaway, or what are the things that I am giving as factors, pointers? It is very much applicable to me. I am also one of your part. Understand this. It's everybody's responsibility. How diligent he is towards giving that. That's when the true definition of the success comes. If the answer to the question of my end goal or my end result or the resultant output that I am giving will be going to the people or will be benefiting the people who are hearing or seeing is coming yes, That means you as an individual is doing a good job. If it is coming with the ambiguous statement or there is no reply at all, your mind is blank, that means you need to think about it and get that clarity, ponder about it. If the answer is no at all, if the answer is coming no, I am not clear with things, I am not at all thought about it, I am not at all giving that end result that benefits the society. It is for me and my own cause, my own development. Then you have to think. Here is where one needs to really think about. Because before even I start my video, before even I do my recordings, so far I have done around 166 videos, close to 165 videos. I think, what is that end result that I am giving? What is the resultant output? How is it benefiting him or her? What is it that, what are the takeaways and what are the pointers that I am giving? Is that useful for anyone who is watching the video? I don't look at likes or comments, but the one who is watching my videos should get enlightened, should understand, should get the gist of it, the subject. This has to be the attitude of everyone as an individual, specifically from the fine arts and cultural field. Not only that, from a teacher, when he or she delivers to the students, it is not the bookish knowledge that you should be giving. It is the practical application that you are giving. You think for a while, think twice, understand it. And at times, we don't change. Our mindset will not change. Our mindset will be the same way as it is from our childhood, because that gets instilled and imbibed and inscribed by default. And that gets carried forward as the age transpires. You do not change. That gets deep rooted in some or the other corner of your body, in your subconscious mind. So when we are doing a kind of service, or when we are doing a kind of this kind of service, like teaching, be it teaching dance, teaching music, teaching subject, teaching whatever theory, theology and all, we need to think in a more broader perspective, more vivid, and we need to have that wider vision towards that aspect. So you have to think from that perspective. This is specifically for parents as well. Parents are no exceptions over here. And unfortunately, this is the mistake my parents did. They never understood what is that message my parents or whomsoever I was associated with. They just had only one thing. Their goals, their results to be successful, positive, reaching that goalpost or aim cast, that's it. They never understood in a more broader and wider sense. I will not blame them for that, my parents or my associates or anyone for that. That was their upbringing. That is what they thought was correct. Things are changing, ladies and gentlemen. We will have to think in a more broader sense, wider sense. And this is specifically applicable in art and culture, because art and culture is all about exhibiting the social causes, social responsibilities, showing those solutions and resolutions towards how to manifest yourself or how to understand yourself. How to understand who am I and what am I and why am I here, what am I doing? Am I correct with what I am doing? Because show goes for a character, if he or she is playing, stays only for 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 30 minutes or 1 hour or 1.5 hour. It doesn't stay for permanently. That character goes off. He or she will play the other character again for 1/2 hour or 1 hour or anything, because nothing is permanent over here. If you are giving a message, let's say like on a social cause, is that permanent solution or the permanent resolution that you are giving, showcasing? Or are you trying to boost yourself, showing your moves or showing your hand movements or leg movements to get the decollets or whatever it is? Let's be honest on this. And this is where the true leadership qualities come into picture. A true leader or a true teacher or a true guide understands this way. For the audience, teacher or guru is the presenter in fine arts and culture. For the students, teacher is the guru who teaches all of this with his or her experience. And this is what is required for a teacher. And teacher has to understand this. Today's teachers do not take this responsibility, unfortunately. I had faced similar kind of situation in one of the place where I wanted to teach spoken English. Unfortunately, she wanted in shortcuts, but she never wanted, she or that school never wanted me to teach at the highest level in a systematic and schematic way. I always took the subject as if this is the last time that I am teaching this subject. If I am teaching for the last time, am I making a mark of it or not? That's a very simple fundamental concept that I have. It's as simple as that. Even these videos, I see as if this is the last speech that I am doing. Every speech, every video that I do, That's what motivates me more. What is it that I am giving? Quality. That is the reason why I say you need to change some things within you as well as seeing the things outside. And none of us are permanent. None of the acts or none of the events that you are seeing outside stay for a longer time. They are not permanent. You don't know what events happen tomorrow. It could be good or bad. You have to go someday. You have to go someday because you are born. And what happens is the moment you finish off your job, you will leave this material world and get to the eternal world. That's it. Let's say N. Ramachandra is there. He is giving speeches and his job is to give speeches and all. He finishes off his job. I as an individual, N. Ramachandra does it. And one fine day what happens is everything is over and the call comes and I need to go. Again, I will have another responsibility on this earth to do. Understand this. It's a very, very simple concept, but presence on your of yours as an individual on this earth is just few minutes. It's a 4 days life. And in this four days life, how are you taming your mind? How are you taming your subconscious state? And what is the best thing that you are doing? What is it that you did for the society? This is what Gayatri Mantra also says. Not only Gayatri Mantra, even this yogic practices, yoga practices and tantric practices also. Let's not use it for negative. That is a reason why if today was the last, what is it that you would do? Let's say I am a professional dancer. I always think if I was a professional dancer, I am not a professional dancer though, I will think, today is my last performance. I am not performing. I will be teaching after this. Out of this performance, what is it that I am doing? What is the end result? What is the end goal? Etc. And you need to make big choices in life during this time. It has to be big choices. When I say big choices, big choices. Big choices doesn't mean that you think something abstract. That you can. And that is helpful for the society. That is helpful for everyone. And who can remember, who can implement in his or her life. At every second, in every second. And they don't remember you as an individual. Let's say if I am giving this video, or if I am creating this video, if I am talking about it, it's more or less like, I don't want people to remember Ramachandra over here. I just want people to remember some XYZ spoke about this. It was useful for me because I have implemented it. I expect this from everyone. So, you need to be remembered as an example. That's it. Bottom line. And that's when these expectations or external expectations or internal expectations get nullified. See that, and you can overcome that space of underlying facts of embarrassments or the moment you don't get it, oh, people will think this way, people will think that way. This will get nullified once you start thinking, if today is my last, what is the best thing that I can do? And you just fall apart or fall away from that aspect. That gets wiped out automatically. And the most important one needs to be understand, one needs to understand is what is the best that you have given in this hour, in the last few minutes of your time. And that last few minutes of your time, if you have given your best and people are remembering, that's when you will be a satisfied person. Forget about the result, forget about the success. Don't think about success or failure. Just do it, that's all. Do your job. Thus, pointers or the key factors from this video is understanding and doing what is right and what is wrong and something that is useful for the society, which will remember you as an example, not as a sample piece. Sample piece is used for some time, but an example remains for a longer time. Understand this. This is for every individual. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Have a nice day ahead. May the Guru's grace be with all of you. Have a nice day ahead.